Thank you very much, Dr. Dabatabai, for introduction. Again, my name is Najphak Hongthanat. I'm a master's student and I'm working with Dr. Kova and Dr. Thompson. And here today, I'm going to present you part of my thesis, and I titled this experiment, the Phosphorus Sorption-Desorption Indices to Estimate Risk of Soil P Loss from Rathbun Lake Watershed. I think everyone knows this very well, that phosphorus is an essential plant nutrient, and we use a lot of phosphorus in Iowa to increase the yield. But the excessive phosphorus that go to the water has a negative impact. Like you can see the algae bloom and then the death of aquatic life. Eventually we have bad drinking water, and it also destroys the aesthetic landscape. In Iowa, source of phosphorus loading right now, it's about the source of phosphorus loading in Iowa come from row crop with the runoff and erosion. It also come from livestock production with the urine and manure that the cattle deposit along the stream. And it's also come from the drainage tile. But how do we assess the risk of phosphorus loss from the soil? The simple way that we use nowadays is to use the conservative soil testing phosphorus. And in Iowa, we use malic 3 extraction. Melolino 2003 has defined the agronomic threshold for the corn production at 20 milligram P per kilogram soil. So, but what if you analyze your soil and what if it's more than 20 milligram P per kilogram? Does the high phosphorus mean the high risk of P loss? You have to think about this. The potential for significant soil P loss to the water depends on two factors. The first one is the concentration of phosphorus in soil, as indicated by malic 3 extraction. The second one that I think many people doesn't concern is the sorption capacity of the soil. Think about you have the same amount of phosphorus to add to the soil, but these two soil has the different sorption capacity to hold the phosphorus. The same amount of phosphorus that you add to the soil. Look at the soil with low sorption capacity. What would happen if you continue add phosphorus to this soil? Of course, the phosphorus that you add will leak out from soil to the water system. Why the soil with high sorption capacity can still hold more phosphorus? How do we measure phosphorus sorption capacity? The technique that many people use is the phosphorus sorption isotherm. And the phosphorus sorption isotherm technique will give us the two parameters, which is very, very important. The first one is the phosphorus sorption maximum. It will tell you the maximum sorption capacity of that soil. The second one is the bonding energy K, which represents the affinity of phosphorus to be sorbed by soil. And phosphorus sorption isotherm is kind of trial and error because you don't know how much phosphorus could be sorbed by your soil. So you have to vary the concentration of phosphorus and see where is the maximum sorption. In this little tube, you have a certain gram of soil and then you vary the concentration of phosphorus. And then you check 24 hours until the equilibrium is reached. I'm going to show you what happens after you add the phosphorus to the soil. The brown chunk that you see right now represent the solid phase. In this case, it is the soil particle. And you can see that there will be the blue circle. That one represents the native phosphorus that in the soil. Actually, that is also called the lay-by phosphorus, and it is the phosphorus that you analyze by Milik 3. Then you add, I forgot one thing. The blue background here represents the solution phase in the system. And after you add phosphorus to this system and wait until the equilibrium is reached, some phosphorus that you add will be absorbed to the soil. Then you measure the phosphorus remaining in solution phase, which is C. To get the amount of phosphorus that's absorbed on solid phase, which is S, you just subtract the phosphorus remaining in solution phase from the initial phosphorus that you add to the soil. Then you get the phosphorus on solid phase. Then you have to plot the relationship between phosphorus on solid phase, which is y-axis, versus the amount of phosphorus in solution phase, which is C, which is x-axis. The question is, where is the maximum sorption? Will the soil continue absorb phosphorus, or will it reach the plateau? To find the maximum sorption capacity of the soil, this graph I will transform to the linear graph, and using the simple linear regression to find the maximum sorption. Actually, the phosphorus sorption data that you get from sorption isotherm, you can fit to other model other than Langmuir. In this study, because I have done the preliminary study and found that the soil sample that I have right now best described by Langmuir model. So I'm going to use Langmuir model. I'm going to plot C over S on the y-axis, and then I still plot C on the x-axis. With the linear regression, the slope of this linear regression equal to 1 over S max. So from you know slope, now you can solve for maximum sorption capacity. And you know that the intercept equal to 1 over K S max. You know intercept, you know S max, now you can find the K, the bonding energy. As you can see that phosphorus sorption isotherm is kind of trial and error, and it's batch experiment. It's time consuming, it's laborious. So many scientists have tried to find if we can use any soil property as an estimator of sorption capacity. Zhang et al. 2005, this group, they are one of many scientists who found that the maximum sorption capacity of the soil rely on the summation of iron and aluminum that extract by ammonium oxalate. Why is it ammonium oxalate? Because ammonium oxalate is a selective solution for the poorly crystallized forms of iron and aluminum oxide. And these poorly crystallized forms has a greater surface area to sorb phosphorus. So far that I told you, like I say, the significance of P loss depends on two factors, the concentration of phosphorus and the sorption capacity. This is the tool that people use nowadays in some state. The degree of phosphorus saturation, it means the amount, the proportion of phosphorus sorption capacity that is occupied by phosphorus. The summation of oxalate ion plus aluminum estimate the sorption capacity of the soil. And the denominator in this equation is the oxalate phosphorus, which represents the amount of phosphorus that already occupied in that soil.
Thank you for watching the Agronomist Podcast. YouTube limits video lengths to 10 minutes. You can watch this seminar in its entirety at the Department of Agronomy website, www.agron.iastate.edu.
Mm-hmm.